Assalamu alaikum and hello friends, welcome to this CodeIgniter 3 video tutorial by Perfect Web Solutions. I'm your host Imran Qasim, and in today's CodeIgniter 3 video tutorial we are going to learn that how can we set up front-end scaffolding using node package manager with CodeIgniter 3. Node package manager is also called npm, so in this video tutorial we will integrate npm, and also in this example I will integrate Vue.js with CodeIgniter so that you can use Vue.js or Vue in your CodeIgniter 3 applications as well. So friends, if before I start this video tutorial, I will request you that if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do consider and subscribe to it, and don't forget to press the bell icon beside the subscribe button so that you can be updated with the notifications whenever I upload a new video or series on any web design or web development topic. Thank you very much. So let's get started with this video tutorial. So friend, before I start this video tutorial, there are some prerequisites which you should complete first. So first prerequisite is that you must install Node.js, and you should know that how can we use npm or node package manager from command line. So how can we install different packages, how can we update them, how can we remove them using npm. So for this example, I'm going to use a package, webpack package of laravel-mix, which is also included in Laravel 5. If you don't know about Laravel, so you don't need to worry about it here, because we are here going to talk about CodeIgniter 3, not about Laravel, but the package we are going to use to build front-end scaffolding called laravel-mix. So first of all, we need to go to the terminal screen. So let me open the terminal here. This is our terminal. So first, navigate, after opening the terminal, navigate to the folder where you have installed your CodeIgniter 3 project. I have in my HD docs and in the folder CI Blade. And if you don't know why I named it CI Blade, so I named it because I have created a previous video tutorial where I've shown you how you can integrate Blade templating engine in CodeIgniter 3. So if you didn't watch that tutorial, watch it and you will learn how you can integrate Blade templating engine with CodeIgniter 3. But in this video tutorial, we are going to integrate node and npm, and we will integrate front-end scaffolding where we will use Vue.js inside CodeIgniter 3. So first of all, I'm CI Blade folder. After that, I must navigate to or create a new folder. Like suppose I create mkdir assets folder, and then I navigate to the assets folder. After going into assets folder, I will generate a package, empty package.json file. So to generate npm, to generate package.json file, I need to write npm in it. And then without any prompt, if I don't want to see any prompt and just create the package.json, I will add the switch y, minus y or dash y, and press enter. And then you can see that default package.json file has been created successfully. Now I will go to my favorite text editor, which is for PHP, and for CodeIgniter is Sublime Text. So let me go to the Sublime Text. Here is our Sublime Text editor, and you can see assets folder is created and package.json folder is already created. Now we need to include a package called laravel-mix. So let me go back to the terminal and I will install npm install minus minus save. Now I will write here minus minus save minus dev, because I want to use it as a development dependency though, so that it won't be included in the production version. So that is why I will use npm install minus minus save minus dev, and then I will just simply do laravel mix. Just wait for a few seconds and everything will be set up properly for you. Okay guys, so Laravel mix at the rate 2.0.0 has been successfully installed as an our package. And if I go to my text editor, and I can show you here node modules, and in node modules you can find easily Laravel mix, because we need to copy few things from it, so that's why I'm navigating to it. So here is a Laravel mix. Yeah, here it is. And the first thing we need, going into setup folder, I need to copy webpack laravel-mix.js, whatever you need, copy this and go into your assets folder which have you created previously. I mean, in the example you have created that folder. So simply let me go to my assets folder, and then I will create new file and I will name it webpack.mix.js. Make sure it is webpack.mix.js file. Save it and then paste those content here, and it will handle everything by its own. So now it's saying that you need a folder src, and then you need to copy two files in it from inside it, app.js and app.scss. So let me create a folder inside assets, and the name of the folder will be src, and in this src folder I will create two files, app.js and another file app.scss, and these two files I will save in the source folder. So this is what this is saying, and it will automatically create a dist folder and copy both of them as CSS file inside that folder, so I don't need to do anything else. Otherwise it have a full API documentation here which you can see with example. So that mix.js, what it will do, it will take the source and give you an output. Same goes for TS, you can do with React as well, you can do Vue also if you can see here options, so extract Vue. Also there is no it will JS, TS, extract, SAS, stand alone. So there are many options with it, but we have no concern with it. We need to work with our Vue.js, integrating Vue.js inside our CodeIgniter 3. So let's get back to the terminal and then run here npm install --- save, and this time we use Vue latest, and then let me get back to the text editor and go to app.js, and here we will do constant view is equal to require view, and then we will do here new view, and we will pass here our variable. So this is our setup, and here we will do app folder, app target, app ID, and there is our data variable, and this is our methods. So everything has been set up. I will set a variable here, msg space, so for example welcome to Vue.js from CodeIgniter 3.1.7. this is the message will be displayed in our welcome message.blade.php file. So we have set up here our app.js, and after that what we need to do, webpack has been set up successfully, so we need to make changes in our package.json. We need to add some scripts. From where we will get those scripts? Of course, inside our node module. We go to Laravel and webpack. This is our package.conf file, and we need to find the scripts. Yeah, here are the scripts. We need these scripts, copy them, and then get back to your package.json file which you have created with npm init and paste them here. So this is our dev, or and this one will be over. We need only a dev version, or I must say a watch which automatically run, and a production. And for this, webpack --- watch --product progress -hide module, and this one will be -p, so it will create a production version -p. So node environment development, we don't need this environment anymore because we haven't set up the environment here. So we will simply remove this, and webpack has been installed inside node modules as well. If it doesn't work for you, then what you need to do is go to your command prompt. If it doesn't work like this, like if you run it, for me it will work. What I have done already is sudo npm. If you are on Windows, then you don't need to run sudo, only Linux or Mac operating system needs sudo. So let me clear this first. So sudo npm install -g webpack. You need to install this package as a global webpack. So I have already installed, so it might take few minutes. Let's see, because it have to look for the updated version, so it might take also few minutes, and then it will be available globally. I can show you. So meantime it get installed, let me check it, watch progress, hide module, that's fine, that's fine. If you want to change anything from here, you don't need. I think Laravel mix has been installed here, view installed here, dependencies and dev dependencies, that is fine. Webpack, our webpack has been initiated successfully. So we need to run our watch command. So you see webpack 3.1.1.0 installed. If I write webpack minus my version, it will show me the version. If it doesn't show you, it means you haven't installed it properly. So what I need to do now, npm run watch. So when I run npm run watch, it will go to package.json and will run this command automatically. So let me run it and see if there's any error. So it says webpack watch progress, no configuration files has been found. So we need to give the path to the configuration files. And where is that configuration file? Inside node module. And inside Laravel mix. Here is Laravel mix. And this is our webpack config.js file. So we need to give the path .node/modules/laravel-mix/setup/webpack.config.js, and same goes for this one. You can write it here or here, it's your choice. I have written in the both sides and it will work. Now I'm sure it will run properly. And it's saying no config file, so no entry configured via CLI. When using CLI, you need to provide at least two arguments, entry and output. So it is saying that entry and output is not defined inside webpack config.js. So let me go to the CodeIgniter, and in the next step, I will open Laravel mix, and it is by jquery. So this one is jquery Laravel mix. Let's open it. Here it is, and here is the documentation. You see basic example, you can see first the basic example. This is the basic example, but we need to complete the installation. So this is all the installation setups, and these are the script. You see here it is configuring to both options, copy, and then go to here inside your package.json file, which you have created here, paste them. And then we don't need this environment here, and we don't need this option webpack. We will simply do webpack. We will simply do here webpack, and here as well webpack dev server. It's also installed webpack dev server, webpack. So this one is over. Minus minus config, and then we have given the path to the config file. So this one is our dev and this one is our watch. So let's save it and then go to the command prompt and npm run watch. And now you see it is configuring our environment, it's building, and it's built successfully. And it's saying multi-source app.js. Let's see, node module, post CSS loader, node module. Yeah, because we have missed some loaders as well. What we need to do here, npm installed minus minus save minus dev sass loader css, because we are using sass, so we will do here sass and css loader. We need to install these two because it's saying here you need normal module and invalid css after app.expected. Let's see. Sorry. Here, source dist ././. This is done. So now npm run watch. And it is saying invalid CSS after app.scss. So there are some errors here, it's showing. Let's see what is the error. This file has been created successfully, and only the problem is this one. You don't need to write here anything like this. Now it is run successfully, and you see the problem. I have written this code which is not understandable, and the loader cannot parse it, so it's giving Laravel mix error. So as soon as I removed it, it fixed the error and build is successful. Now we have set up our view, and whatever we need to make changes, we need to make in app.js. And before, make sure you have run npm run watch this command. So now our webpack has been configured successfully. Make sure your package.json file have CSS loader, SAS loader, and Laravel mix in it, and these scripts are properly copied, and you have globally installed webpack in your computer or machine. Otherwise, you have to use the local version by giving it node modules path, and then you can just like this, you can copy webpack.js from within this node modules locally which you have installed. Anyway, webpack and webpack dev server, these both should be installed. Otherwise, we normally don't need this, and we only need watch and production. That's two things we need only. So these are okay here. You know, let's see the live example. So here I have written msg and we have target app. So it means if I go to applications, views, welcome blade.php, first of all we need to add our app.css in head. So I will use, of course, curly brackets, because as you know that I have already configured CI Blade with Blade templating engine, and I have created a video tutorial in the same playlist which you have just watching this video tutorial. You can watch it and enjoy it. So after that, I need to write assets slash CSS slash app.css. It is in the dist folder. Inside the dist folder, I think assets, dist app.js and dist app.css. So app.js has been added here, and then we will add the JS file here before the body close. So script src is equal to base URL assets slash dist slash app.js, and that's it. After that, I don't need any of these things up to here. Let me keep this version information, and I will create app ID. And inside app ID, I will simply call msg, which I have created here inside app.js file inside src folder. So now let's go to the browser and run the CodeIgniter again, and you will see use of undefined const msg, because we have integrated Blade templating engine, and this code is running. The engine thinks it is a variable created by PHP, but it is not. It is the variable created by Vue.js. So it means we need to put at the symbol here, or we need to put vhtml is equal to msg here. In both cases, it will work. Now let me do it with this. msg id app, and let me msg. Sorry, at the rate msg, and here it is showing msg, and but it's not showing that the path is, maybe let me see the path of JS file. So assets is giving a space here. Yeah, this is the problem. It shouldn't be a space. There shouldn't be a space. So make sure there is no space. And now if I open it, now it's loaded successfully. So let me go back and run the command again, and then you see welcome to Vue.js from CodeIgniter 3.1.7, which is coming from over Vue.js. This is coming from over Vue.js. Now even if you go to app.css inside source folder, app.scss, here you can write your command related to CSS, like body, background, I put 333EEE or 333 whatever, and save it, and it will compile and run it automatically. And when you run, you see the background has been changed. You can also do h2 color red, go back, reload the page, and you see the color is red. So now I'm working with app.scss, app.js. If you have any third party CSS, you can easily integrate it here inside your app CSS, scss. Simply what you need to do, import URL, like node dot dot slash node modules slash bootstrap slash scss slash bootstrap dot scss. Now you will say that from where this will come. Of course, we need to install it, and let me pause it and npm installed minus minus save bootstrap at the rate latest. So we are doing now everything via npm. We are installing our packages via npm, and we are using just like Vue. We have now adding bootstrap as well. So it is done, and there are some other error that it needs a jquery. It is saying it needs AJV keyword, the pair of AJV, but non-install popper.js and jquery.js also needed, because bootstrap.min.js need jquery. So let's install jquery as well. jquery as well as popper.js at the rate latest and AJV at the rate latest. So AJV 6.1.1, popper.js 1.12.9, jquery 3.3.1 also installed. And now let's see how to integrate. So CSS file we can integrate via app.scss, and over JS files we can write here window.$ is equal to require bootstrap. We can do bootstrap like this. And after that, we can write over jquery here inside, like it is installed here inside the node modules and in bootstrap. And here is our JS. Here is our SCSS folder inside bootstrap. So JS, we have different kinds of. So it means for adding here, we need to give it the path of the JS file, which we need to import here. So we can say node.slash.dot.slash, because we need to go one step back, node modules slash bootstrap slash dist folder slash js and slash bootstrap.min.js, and also we can simply do require here, and then we also need to require jquery. So slash node modules slash jquery, and also we need jquery. Yeah, here it is, jquery dist, jquery slash dist slash jquery dot min dot JS. And after bootstrap jquery, we do need popper. So require dot slash node module, we need to put double dot here because we need to go one step back. So node modules slash popper dot JS, and there are two I think version of popper. One is UMD and one is popper. Yeah, here it is, dist and UMD. We need UMD folder, popper.js slash UMD slash popper.min.js. So we need to include these three require files, and we will require them here so that they can also be integrated within our file. So run npm run watch again, and let's see if there is any error. I'm sure there shouldn't be any. So here it's saying cannot resolve popper, and I think spelling mistake, UMD popper dot popper dot js slash dist and now I think now Laravel build and compile successfully. So now we can have bootstrap and JS also included inside our app.js, and inside our app.css we have this, and it didn't import it. Let me see why it did not import it. App.css import node module bootstrap. Let's see what is the problem here. Assets node modules and node modules bootstrap. bootstrap, and scss bootstrap.scss import URL. This one is fine. Error. Let's see what is the error. The same module cannot resolve bootstrap. Okay, let's include the rendered version, CSS version here rather than SCSS. So go into dist folder slash CSS slash bootstrap dot min dot CSS and then save it. And after that, it compiles successfully. Now reload the page, and now we have integrated successfully bootstrap inside over. And you can see now it is on the top right corner because bootstrap has been implemented, and now it means we can use bootstrap, we can use Vue with our project here in CodeIgniter. So this is how you use webpack and package.json file to create your own app.js and app.css, and here you will write your customized code which will overridden. If you want to override any bootstrap class, you can override it here. So now let's go to application folder views, and then you can create any like dot container, or I must say, let me write it here, dot container dot row dot call sm 6 dot call sm here offset md sm 3 and here we will put our h2 tag, and when we reload we have successfully done it. So this is how we can install Vue.js as well. Now you see we have here Vue.js. Now we can work here with app.js. We can create a new folder here inside your dist. You can create, or I do recommend creating it in a source folder and name it components, and we can write Vue components here. So new file and my component, name it whatever you want. Yeah, test component dot vue, save it, and inside component we have this Vue component. Now we can write template, we can write script, and we can write style, right? So we can write in the template whatever we want to write, like h3 tag msg, this is msg from here, and in the script we do export default, and here we will do our data and return msg hello from component, save it, and if everything goes good, it's compiled successfully. And now we need to import our component here. So let's see how can we import. Constant test component is equal to require dot slash components slash test component. So this component has been imported, imported here. There are some issues here, bubble loader. So dot view export, I think it is export default and not export. So let's save it, and now it's success. So the problem was it is export default, not exports default. So guys, now we have successfully imported our component here. So what we can do here, components, and we can here add our component like test. We can write it test and test component. Then we have this tag created component, and we forgot to put a comma here. So now it's built successfully. It means now if we go to app view, and here we can also write test like this, and go to our terminal, and hello from component also displayed in the same context where it is displayed as welcome to Vue.js from CodeIgniter 3.17. So friend, I think you, and I'm sure you have understood now that how can we create views here using Vue. We can same like in Laravel, what we are doing, we can do same thing now here. We can make changes over changes here. We can create new components here, and we can we are good to go to use Vue.js, or even we can configure React.js as well. If you see here, you have mix React option, which will help you to compile and output your React.js code. So it says identical to Mix.js, but register React Babel compilation. So this is these are the options which you can use with Mix.js, which is Laravel Mix. And this is the video tutorial of today. I'm sorry it gets a bit longer than usual because of those few glitches, but I'm sure that if you watch this tutorial completely, you will definitely understand many things, many concepts. If still there are things which you haven't understand or you misunderstand them, do let me know in the comment section below, or you can join our WhatsApp group as well. Here now I should stop this video tutorial here and say thank you very much for being with me till end. Take care, Allah Hafiz, and bye.